Hey guys, welcome to another Acropolis Tech Topics. Today we're going to be talking about the image service. This is a really cool feature that allows you to import ISOs and disk images directly into the ADSF using Prism, and then attach them to VMs and either install your OS from them or make clones from them. Let's go take a look at it.
Okay, so here we are. We've logged into Prism. If I click on the gear in the top right corner here and go to Image Configuration, I can see a list of images that are currently on the system. As you can see, I've got two right now, a CentOS ISO and Ubuntu ISO. I'm going to go to Upload Image to add a new one. I'm going to be uploading a Windows 2012. And I've got two options for image type here. ISO would be for CD images, which you'd use for install disks, driver CDs, that sort of thing. Disk would be something like a RAW file, a VMDK, a VHDX, the kind of things that come from another hypervisor. So I'm going to choose ISO. Next, you can choose the container you want to put it on. I'm just going to leave it on test. Now, I've got two options for uploading. For this first ISO, I'm going to upload from a file because I have the installer already in my PC. If I go here to downloads, I've got the ISO right there. And I click save. Now we get this nice progress window showing us the upload. Okay, so now the image is completed, and now we see Windows 2012 R2 here. Now I need to add a second ISO for the VertIO CD. In this case, I'm going to pull it right from Nutanix portal. So I go here to the portal, downloads, tools and firmware. I've got the VertIO CD right here. Now, since my cluster has access to the external web, I can use this direct link and upload from there rather than having to download it and upload it again. And there we go. So now we see that we've got the Nutanix VertIO disk and the Windows 2012 R2 disk. Let's go create a VM with these disks. So when I go in here to create a VM, I choose New Disk. And I go down to Operation here, you see that I have a clone from image service. When I choose this option, the window changes, and I get this new image box down here. This only shows me images that are in the image service, and so then I can choose an ISO directly from there. This allows me to simply and easily upload images to Prism and use them when creating VMs.
As you can see, the image service is really easy to use. Now, one thing you might be concerned about is disk usage, because you can only clone from the image service. The important thing to note is that these are Nutanix clones. So, when we have our ISO here in the image service, and we attach it to a VM, it actually creates a clone of this, a metadata-only clone. This is the same if it was a raw disk image or any other image format imported into the image service. Because this is just a metadata-only clone, it doesn't use any extra space, but if you make any changes to this, it's persistent and doesn't affect the base image. Thanks for joining us here for this episode of Tech Topics in the Acropolis series, and make sure to check out the other ones in the Acropolis series to learn more.